Computer science is at the core of just about everything we do and have done at NASA. From the development of the groundbreaking software that landed the first astronauts on the moon during the Apollo era, much of it calculated and coded by women, our very own hidden figures, to the programming that keeps the International Space Station in its orbit and ensures the humans aboard it are safe, healthy, and productive. Coding is essential to our mission. Computer scientists play critical roles in NASA's missions and humanity's progress. It's because of computer scientists that we can see into our universe's past and plan for humanity's future on other planets.
My name is Aram Hamidi.
I'm Dr. Stephanie Milam.
My name is Philip Hargrove, and I formerly worked as a launch vehicle trajectory analyst.
I am a planetary scientist at NASA Goddard Space Flight Center.
And I'm a data scientist working at NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory. When I was younger, I was always fascinated with robots and gadgets. When I got older, I realized that the brain of a robot is really a computer. And the way to make it smarter is to code programs in it.
Coding is a way of just communicating with a machine to get it to do what you want to do. You're just speaking in that computer's language, so you just have to learn how to speak to that computer. And once you do that, it's really just a matter of communicating with it.
Coding is a very critical part of what we do day in, day out, and is absolutely essential for almost all astronomical data. We're manipulating digital formats of data and converting them into something more beautiful and more spectacular.
In my trajectory analyst job, coding was really important because that was our way of feeding all of the math equations into a system that could tell us whether or not we were going to the right place. We help make sure that the spacecraft that scientists spend years, maybe even decades working on, they get where they're supposed to go. I mean, these people are designing the spacecraft, they're building it, they're testing it, and then it really all converges to, you know, one day at the launch pad, and it has to work right. Once those engines lift off and you get off the pad, it's either a yay or a nay. Our job as an analyst is really just to feed in all of those equations, all of those numbers, and make sure that NASA's missions are successful.
I use computer science every day in my job at NASA, mostly to analyze images that we're taking with the James Webb Space Telescope. We get this data down in a very primitive form. It's a, you know, digital version of these beautiful images. And we have to take that digital form and transform it into something that looks like the fantastic pictures that you see. So we use coding to actually do that transformation.
We receive a lot of scientific data from the spacecrafts. As a data scientist, I can look into a specific data, for example, images that Perseverance sends back us to Earth, and find interesting patterns in those images that can help us answer some questions about the surface of Mars.
I got interested in computer science and coding through my job to do and analyze the spectra and the images that we collect from the James Webb Space Telescope. We have to have coding in order to interpret the data that we collect from the telescope. This is something that doesn't come naturally, and it's actually part of almost every astronomer's career.
I actually was intimidated by physics and math myself, but then I realized if I spend enough time and enjoy thinking about solving problems, then all of a sudden they become a lot easier.
My advice to students that are intimidated by computer science or STEM or science in general is to not be afraid, to take it one step at a time. Coding is actually a very important part of what we do as scientists, astronomers, and chemists, biologists. We all use coding every day to help with the analysis and interpretation of our data. It's not something that's easy to anybody, and it takes a lot of practice and work to get used to. But once you get the hang of it, it starts coming as a second language, which is the pure irony of calling it a language in and of itself.
The advice that I would give to anybody who is intimidated by STEM or coding is just to recognize that people do it as a team. You know, the best work gets done by a team, and working as a team is really what helped us, contribute to NASA's mission.
We go places that no one has been before, and we dare mighty things every day. And we get to answer some questions about our universe.
There are so many opportunities at NASA for people interested in coding, programming, and software development. You could navigate robots on other worlds. You can create programs to help astronauts explore new horizons. You can visualize data to show what otherwise cannot be seen. With each generation of computer scientists, we've been able to explore more and more of the universe. It's exciting to think about what we'll discover next.